Hi students, welcome to Karthik Chemistry channel. Today I want to teach you composite materials. So what is composite material? Composite may be defined as multi-phase materials consisting of two or more distinct phases with an interface separating them. Okay, out of several composite materials, the main composite materials are fiber reinforced plastics, glass fiber reinforced plastics, carbon fiber reinforced plastics and bulletproof plastics. So what is fiber reinforced plastic? The combination of polymeric substance with solid fillers such as fiber is a reinforcing material. Okay, the combination of polymeric substance with fiber as a reinforcing material is called fiber reinforced plastic. Okay, see here, the filler acts as a reinforcing material and the polymer links the filler particles. Okay, the polymer acts as a binder to hold the filler particles. So here the filler particles may be fiber, glass fiber or carbon fiber. If the filler particles are fiber, so then such type of plastics are called fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, so here the fillers are solid additives which modify the physical properties. Okay, mainly here the filler particles modify the physical properties and mechanical properties. So what are the mechanical properties? Thermal stability, mechanical strength, insulating characteristics, water resistance, rigidity, hardness, opacity. These all properties will give the filler particles to the polymer. Okay, so here the reinforcing fibers may be either organic substances or inorganic substances. Okay, so they are like jute, asbestos, glass, carbon, silicon carbide, nylon, polyester, aramids, etc. Okay, so here the two components, namely the fiber and the resin means the polymer, are binded in a suitable manner. Okay, what are the two components here? Fiber and resin. Okay, the fiber plus polymer gives rise to, here fiber plus polymer equal to FRP. Here the fiber is the reinforcing material and the resin is the polymer. These two combined together leads to the formation of fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, so the fiber reinforced plastics are characterized by high specific strength, mainly high specific strength, and are used to carry load along the length of the fiber. These are the methods used to produce FRP. So to produce fiber reinforced plastics, the methods used are continuous lamination, okay, molding process, injection molding, spray up technique, right? So these are the methods used to produce fiber reinforced plastic. So the first one is continuous lamination. Here the reinforcing fibers are impregnated with resin and then run through laminating rolls between cellophane sheets to control the thickness and resin content. Okay, then they are cured in heating chamber. That is the first technique, continuous lamination. And then the second one is molding process. Here the mass production of this technique is for mass production of high strength parts. Okay, mass production of high strength parts. And then injection molding. So here a mix of short fibers and resin are forced by a screw conveyor. We have discussed in molding techniques. We have already discussed in molding techniques. So here the plastic material, the component plastic material along with fiber is forced into the cavity through screw conveyor. Okay, so and the next technique is spray up technique. So in spray up technique, the mix of fiber and resin is projected by a designed spray gun so that they are deposited on the surface of the mold. Okay, so then the curing is done with a catalyst at room temperature. These are the four techniques adopted for preparing fiber reinforced plastics. So what are the advantages? What are the properties of fiber reinforced plastics? So these are the properties. They are light and strong. Fiber reinforced plastics are light and very strong. Low coefficient of thermal expansion and low dielectric constant. Okay, fiber reinforced plastics have low coefficient of thermal expansion and low dielectric constant. They are not easily corroded and non-inflammable. Fiber reinforced plastics are not easily corroded. And fiber reinforced plastics have high dimensional stability. It has, these materials have good dimensional stability. That means the dimensions of the material do not change with temperature and etc. These have high resistance to abrasion and have high impact strength. Abrasion means scratching resistance. Fiber reinforced materials, fiber reinforced plastics have high resistance to abrasion. Okay. And fiber reinforced plastics, that means the mold articles from FRP can be repaired easily. Fiber reinforced plastics can be repaired very easily. And the cost of production is very less. These materials have high melting point. Okay. These are the properties of fiber reinforced plastics. So what are the applications? Fiber reinforced plastics are used in land transportation. So these are the applications. Okay, students, see here. So these plastics are used in land transportation, in construction, marine equipment, in corrosion resistance equipment, electrical and electronic industry, aircraft, aerospace and military goods, automobiles and various appliances and business articles. Okay, these are the applications of fiber reinforced plastics. And then glass fiber reinforced plastics. Then another composite material is glass fiber reinforced plastics, simply GFRP. What is glass fiber reinforced plastic? The combination of polymeric substance with glass fiber as a reinforcing agent. Here the reinforcing agent is glass fiber. Glass fiber gives external support to the plastic material. Okay, so the combination of polymeric substance, the combination of polymer with glass fiber as a reinforcing agent. Here the reinforcing agent is glass fiber. Okay, so how the glass fiber is formed? Glass fiber is made by mixing sand, limestone, folic acid and other minor ingredients. Okay, we get glass fiber. Okay, so these glass fiber is mixed with polymer, then GFRP is formed. Okay, so the molten glass is drawn into fibers in the form of filaments and woven in the form of mats. This fiber material is suitably bonded with plastic materials to get glass fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, the common plastic resins used are polyesters, silicone, vinyl derivatives and other polyamides. Okay, so simply glass fiber reinforced plastic means the combination of polymer with glass fiber as a reinforcing material. Okay, so polymer plus glass fiber equal to glass fiber reinforced plastics. What are the properties? These are the properties of glass fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, these have low densities. Glass fiber reinforced materials, glass fiber reinforced plastics have low densities, high tensile strength. That means tensile strength means load bearing capacity, high impact resistance. These materials have high impact resistance and good thermal resistance. And glass fiber reinforced plastics have excellent chemical and corrosion resistance. Okay, these are the properties of glass fiber reinforced plastics. So and then applications. Where we find applications of GFRP? We find applications in automobile parts, storage tanks, industrial flooring, plastic pipes, and in transportation industries. Okay, so in transportation industries, to reduce vehicle weight and to increase fuel efficiency. So in transportation industries, they prepare the articles or the materials prepared with GFRP is having very less weight, so that increase the fuel efficiency. Okay, so glass fiber reinforced plastic means the combination of polymeric substance with glass fiber as a reinforcing agent. Okay, how glass fiber is formed? Glass fiber is formed by mixing sand, limestone and folic acid, right? So what are the common plastic resins here? The common plastic resins used in GFRP are polyesters, silicone, vinyl derivatives and polyamides, right? So these are the properties. So these are the properties of glass fiber reinforced plastics, and these are the applications of glass fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, and then carbon fiber reinforced plastics. So what is carbon fiber reinforced plastic? The combination of polymeric substance with carbon fiber as a reinforcing material. Okay, here what is the reinforcing material? What is the reinforcing agent? Carbon fiber as a reinforcing agent. That means plastic plus carbon fiber is equal to carbon fiber reinforced plastic. Okay, so here carbon fiber is formed by mixing carbon black with fiber. Then the carbon fiber is a reinforcing material for plastic. Okay, so simply CFRP is formed by combination of carbon fiber with plastic as a main material. Okay, so what is the advantage of carbon fibers? What is the very good property of carbon fiber? Carbon fibers have high modulus of elasticity. Carbon fiber material has high modulus of elasticity comparing with FRP and GFRP. Okay, so fiber reinforced plastics and glass fiber reinforced plastics have no elastic property, but carbon fibers have some modulus of elasticity. Okay, high modulus of elasticity. So these are resistant to many chemical solutions and do not show any creep or relaxation, right? So what are the properties of carbon fiber reinforced plastic? So carbon fiber reinforced plastics are alkali resistant. That means these materials do not react with bases. Okay, and they are resistant to corrosion, right? And then they have low thermal conductivity. They have short curing time. Molded articles can be repaired easily, and articles can be cured very less time. Articles can be ejected. Okay, they are bad conductors of electricity and non-magnetic. That means these are good insulators. They have high fatigue resistance, and fabricated components of CFRP can be easily transported due to their light weight. So carbon fiber reinforced plastics are also light materials, light in weight, like GFRP, glass fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, so carbon fiber reinforced plastic means the combination of polymeric substance with carbon fiber as a reinforcing agent, and these are the properties. And then bulletproof plastics. The next composite material is bulletproof plastics, and these are also called aramid fiber reinforced plastics. Bulletproof plastics are aramid plastics or polyamide plastics. Okay, so what is bulletproof plastic? A bulletproof plastic is a strong transparent material. Okay, strong material, transparent material, which is resistant to penetration of bullets. Then such type of materials are called bulletproof plastics. Okay, so bulletproof plastic means they are strong, they are transparent, which is resistant to penetration of bullets. So aramid is a short form of aromatic polyamide. These are aromatic compounds. So it is a aromatic polyamide, बुलेट प्रूफ प्लास्टिक्स आर एरोमेटिक पॉलीमर्स. केवलर एंड नॉमेक्स आर बिलोंग टू दिस कैटेगरी. दैट मीन्स द मेन बुलेट प्रूफ प्लास्टिक्स आर केवलर एंड नॉमेक्स विच आर यूज टू मेक थिंग्स लाइक बुलेट प्रूफ वेस्ट्स, पंक्चर रेसिस्टेंट बाइसिकल्स, बाइसिकल टायर्स, बुलेट प्रूफ जॉकेट्स एटसेट्रा. ओके, सो वॉट आर द मेन बुलेट प्रूफ मेटीरियल्स, बुलेट प्रूफ प्लास्टिक मेटीरियल्स? केवलर एंड नॉमेक्स. वॉट इज केवलर, वॉट इज नॉमेक्स? सो केवलर इज ए पॉली पैराफिलिन टर्थैलामाइड. पॉली पैराफिनिलिन टर्थैलामाइड. ओके, सो दिस मटेरियल इज फॉर्म्ड बाय कंडेंसेशन पॉलीमराइजेशन. दैट मीन्स पॉली पैराफिनिलिन टर्थैलामाइड इज ए कंडेंसेशन पॉलीमर विच इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सेवरल मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ पैराफिनिलिन डायमीन एंड टर्थैलाइल क्लोराइड. ओके, केवलर इज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सेवरल मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ पैराफिनिलिन डायमीन एंड टर्थैलाइल क्लोराइड. पैराफिनिलिन डायमीन, सो फिनिलिन ग्रुप NH2 NH2, सो फिनिलिन ग्रुप COCl COCl, एसिड क्लोराइड ग्रुप टर्थैलाइल क्लोराइड. ओके, सो इट इज अ कंडेंसेशन पॉलीमर. सो बाय द रिमूवल ऑफ सेवरल मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ HCl, सो यू कैन सी द स्ट्रक्चर हियर. हियर एलिमिनेशन ऑफ HCl टेक्स प्लेस. ओके, देन द लिंकेज इज NHCO. सो इट इज पॉली पैराफिनिलिन टर्थैलामाइड. इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सेवरल मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ पैराफिनिलिन डायमीन एंड टर्थैलाइल क्लोराइड. ओके, इट इज ए पैरा आइसोमर. एंड देन नॉमेक्स. नॉमेक्स इज अनदर कैटेगरी ऑफ बुलेट प्रूफ प्लास्टिक्स. सो इट इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय कंडेंसेशन पॉलीमराइजेशन ऑफ मेटाफिनिलिन डायमीन एंड आइसोथैलाइल क्लोराइड. इन केस ऑफ केवलर दैट इज ए पैराफिनिलिन डायमीन एंड टर्थैलाइल क्लोराइड. एंड इन केस ऑफ नॉमेक्स इट इज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मेटाफिनिलिन डायमीन एंड आइसोथैलाइल क्लोराइड. मेटाफिनिलिन डायमीन एंड आइसोथैलाइल क्लोराइड. ओके, सो इट इज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सेवरल मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ metaphenylene diamine. See here, metaphenylene diamine, it is the structure of metaphenylene diamine. Okay, so meta positions NH2 NH2, so n molecules, several molecules, and isothalyl chloride meta positions. So acid chloride group COCl COCl, isothalyl chloride. So by the combination of these two molecules, so several molecules of metaphenylene diamine and isothalyl chloride, we get a polymer that is called simply nomex. Okay, nomex. So these are bulletproof plastics, Kevlar and nomex. So what are the properties? These are the properties of bulletproof plastics. So bulletproof plastics have low density, lightweight, these are lightweight materials, so they are low density materials, high strength, good impact resistance, good abrasion resistance, good chemical resistance, good resistance to thermal degradation. These are the properties of bulletproof plastics. So what are the properties of bulletproof plastics? Bulletproof plastics have low density, high strength, good impact resistance, good abrasion resistance, good chemical resistance, and good resistance to thermal degradation. So where we find applications of bulletproof plastics? They are used in bulletproof vests, aircraft body parts, boat hulls, protective apparel such as gloves, motorcycle protective clothing and parts, in fiber optics and electromechanical cables. Okay, These are the applications of bulletproof plastics. These are the composite materials. Okay, students, write down the notes. So the first one is fiber reinforced plastic. Okay, the composite materials are fiber reinforced plastics, glass fiber reinforced plastics, carbon fiber reinforced plastics, and aramid plastics. Okay, composite material means multi-phase material consisting of two or more distinct phases with an interface separating them. Okay, so first one is fiber reinforced plastics. Write down the notes. The combination of polymeric substance with fiber as a reinforcing agent. Here the external supporting agent is fiber. So fiber gives external strength to the plastic material. Okay, if fiber gives external strength to the plastic material, then such type of plastics are called fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, so fabrication of FRP, the main fabrication methods are continuous lamination, molding process, injection molding, spray up technique. These are the fabrication methods of fiber reinforced plastics. And these are the properties of fiber reinforced plastics, properties and then applications. These are the applications of fiber reinforced plastics. Okay, write down the notes. And then glass fiber reinforced plastics, the combination of polymeric substance with glass fiber as a reinforcing materials. Glass fibers are mainly formed by mixing of sand, limestone, folic acid. Then carbon fiber reinforced plastics. Carbon fibers have high modulus of elasticity. Comparing with FRP and GFRP, carbon fibers have high modulus of elasticity. Okay, write down the notes. Glass fiber reinforced plastics, properties and applications. Carbon fiber reinforced plastics, these are the properties of carbon fiber reinforced plastics. And then bulletproof plastics. So bulletproof plastic means a strong transparent material which is resistant to penetration of bullets. These are aromatic polyamides. Aramid is a short form of bulletproof plastics. So bulletproof plastics are also called aramid plastics. The main bulletproof plastics are Kevlar and Nomex. Kevlar, Nomex. You can write the structures. Nomex. Kevlar is a para isomer and Nomex is a meta isomer. Okay. Thank you, students.